Hey everyone, this is part 3 video from the Digital Art for Beginners series where I paint very minimalistic and fun to create 2D artworks. I also try to share my process of work and some tips, tricks and techniques that I've learned from my experience and from some other very experienced educators on the internet. And today in this video, we are going to paint this cute artwork. A little note here that this tutorial is not a software specific tutorial, so you can use any other software of your choice and I believe you would still be able to get similar results, or maybe even better than that, who knows. So as always, I'll start the process by sketching the idea very roughly, and as you know that most of the utensils like cup, plate and glass are symmetrical in nature. So to save my time sketching the other half, I'll be using this symmetrical drawing tool. This tool is a very powerful tool and the good thing is that it's available in most of the drawing programs out there, so you can easily continue with it. Also, to make the ideation and exploration part easy and fun, first try using a pencil brush instead of a very flat brush with no textures in it. And second, the size of your brush should be a little larger than the size of your final strokes that you have in your head. Now the reason here is very simple, that bigger brush would not allow you to work on the detailing part right away, which is like the best thing for exploration because at this particular stage, you are not supposed to focus on the detail. You can always turn off the symmetrical tool where you think you don't need it. Likewise, I didn't need it while sketching the weaving hand and the cup holder, so I'm gonna turn it off and continue with my sketching. Now here at this point, I'm very much satisfied with my sketch. And you see, just by looking at it, you can very well imagine how it would turn out with all the lights and colors in it. By the way, for the inking, I'm not planning to use the brush tool. Instead, I will go with this Bezier curve tool because I need the clean lines here, not some wobbly lines. For the Photoshop users, it's the pen tool. Now let's create a new layer and paint a background. I didn't like this blue background very much because I think it wasn't going well with the rest of the artwork, so I changed it in the end. I also went for tweaking the colors of my other elements as well, and you see, it's very beneficial if you paint the very important elements on individual layers, because later, once the whole artwork is completed, it gets very ponderous to modify anything. So I recommend you all to paint the very important element on separate layers. And the reason I am preaching this is because in this very video, I myself made the same mistake that I did not paint some of the important elements on different layers, like this plate on a separate layer and the hands on another separate layers. And that's the reason that I had to use selection tool very frequently to paint the details. So I suggest you not to repeat the same mistake as I did. Now let's jump on to the rendering part. Usually for the soft detailing, I prefer soft round brush. And for the rim kind of light, I prefer hard round brush. Now further process is very repetitive and it's simple. And I have already explained the basic concept of getting lighting right in the part 2 of this video series. So if by any chance you haven't seen that video, go check that video. Link is there in the description as well as the pinned comment below. I actually have plans to make dedicated videos on these specific topics like light, shade and rendering, so you gotta stick around for more amazing videos coming up next. Congratulations guys, you can now take a minute to tap on your shoulder and give yourself a very tight hug for doing this wonderful job. I admit that I'm not one of those highly experienced artists out there, so if there is anything I can improve, please let me know. I'll see you all next week. Till then, take care and keep creating.